we started virtual VBS this week. Virtual VBS will be sent out via our e-blast every Monday in July. We are looking for youth leaders who are able to help. If you're interested in helping with virtual VBS, please let me know. So for the past 4 weeks, we've been talking about justice and how it is more than just a hashtag. Our world is not as it should be. There is pain, evil, and injustice all around us. In the age of social media, it's easier than ever to stay informed about all sorts of injustices, but is sending a tweet, posting a selfie, or sharing a video about an inspiring cause really all it takes to make a difference in this world? Or is it possible that justice is about something much more than just a hashtag? We've challenged you to not just post about the injustices around you, but to actually do something about them by loving mercy, acting justly, and walking humbly. Our scripture focus for the month has been Micah 6:8. He has told you what is good, and what does the Lord require of you, but to do justice, to love mercy, and to walk humbly with your God. For the last 4 weeks, we've spent time exploring how you can do just that. How do we approach justice not as another hashtag or trendy social media campaign, but as a lifelong mission of making wrong things right in Jesus' name? We said our journeys towards justice start when we decide to do something. We said God's heart for justice is less about punishment and more about showing mercy. We talked about the many ways that we change our behavior in order to act more justly. And last week, we finished up with a reminder to follow Jesus' example and to walk humbly with God. In the last 4 weeks, I hope you've been challenged to let God use you to make wrong things right. And I hope you take his invitation to join him on his mission in the world. So how do we do that? Today, I want to talk about how you can live out Micah 6:8 in your lives and in your homes. In the comment section of this video, you'll find a helpful document with ideas on how to seek justice. It's broken down into three causes: physical, relational, and systemic. There are some justice issues that can be addressed by meeting people's physical needs. There are other justice issues that require a relational investment. There are other justice issues that can't be solved in a day or by a single individual. These issues require prolonged, large-scale action and organization. I encourage you to use this document in any of our more than a hashtag Bible studies to lead conversations in your home about seeking justice. What can you do this week to seek justice, love mercy, and walk humbly with God?